Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss the 4 problems from the latest contest from LeetCode, bi-weekly contest 34, problem name count all possible routes. So you are given an array of distant positive integers location, where location I represent the position of city I. So as you can see in this like test input which is given, location I means that the first city is on the coordinate 2, second city is on coordinate 3 and so on. Also, you can see that they are not actually sorted also. So the like the fifth city is on coordinate 4. Okay, so like the cities are numbered and the position of them like referencing from 0, it is given on a number line. Now you can also give an integer start and finish and fuel. So these are the three things which are also given to you. Start means on which city you start. So 1 means that you start on the first city and you end up on the third city. And then what you'll actually have to do here is, at each step, if you are at any city I, so let's assume that you are at any city I, then you can pick any city j, like from I you can go to any city j such that j is not equal to I, and the location and like j is less than or equal to the location length. So what does this mean? It actually mean that, okay, let's assume that you are on the city and you want to go on the city. So let's draw it out to make it more clear. So because it is from 1 to 8, let's draw out some numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now the first city is on 2, 3, 6, 8. So 2, 3, 6, 8, and then the last city is on 4. Okay, now the question statement states that you are starting at the position 1, the city 1. Okay, and now you end up on the city like 3. So you want to go to the city and now you have some fuel in your car. Let's assume it is equal to 5 units. So now you can use this fuel, but how this fuel is consumed such that if you know the distance between, like if you are on the city, like if you are on any city I, and if you want to go to, let's assume that some city like this, which is J, then difference between these two cities is the distance between them. The distance between them is this, which is 1 and 4. So different like distance between them is 2. So 2 unit of fuel is consumed. So now actually what the question statement states that, let's assume that your N city is this and your first city is this. So like you can either move from this first city to this city directly. The distance between this city and this city is equal to 6 minus 2, which is 4. So you can directly travel to this city because you have 5 units in your car. Also, what you can do, you can first go from one city to the second city. The fuel consumed is 3 minus 2, which is 1. And then go from 3 to 6. So the fuel consumed is 6 minus 3, which is 3, which is equal to 4. And which is also less than 5. So like you can also go in this way or in this fashion, or you can like go from start from, let's assume that if you start from the city I, you always start from city 1, and then like you go on to some cities and then like you end up on the city. Then the question statement states that how many routes are possible to reach the final city. That's the whole question. Now like assuming that you have this amount of fuel, because the question statement is the fourth question also and the constraints are very small, as you can see. So it will actually tell you that it is a DP problem. Okay, also the like this problem can be solved in a simpler way, because how you can set the states of DP. If you are, so let's assume that you want to reach the final city, which is equal to the city 3. Okay, if you know that my car is having some fuel which is like 1, you can easily tell that, okay, I can reach this final city from any city which has a distance less than or equal to 1. Because like if any city has less than or equal to 1 distance, then only I can reach that city. Now if my fuel is 2, then I can reach from this city to this city, from 5 to 3. Okay, but if my like fuel is 3, or I can also reach from this to this city 3, from 4 to 3 if my fuel is 2. If my fuel is 3, I can reach from these cities also, and I can also reach from this city 2 to 3, because the distance between them is 3. I hope you understand this part now. So what you can easily do here is, I will like remove some part. Yeah. So now what you can easily do here is, so start out from the like first city for every fuel, like for fuel, let's assume that because your fuel is equal to, let's assume that 10. So for every fuel position, let's assume that you have fuel 10, fuel 9, fuel 8, fuel 7 and so on. Let's assume that you have fuel 10 initially and you start at the position which is equal to the starting point. Now what you can do here is, let's see whichever city you can go with this fuel 10. Okay, let's assume that I can go to the city. I can go to the city. Okay, so what you can do, I will initialize this city with 1 because I have one path, because like I have to initialize the initial city with 1. Now if I can go to this city, this correspond to one path. Okay, so what you can do, you can correspond this movement to one path and so on. So you can initialize all this to 1. So you can make a DP table. This is fuel, the first value is fuel and the second value is the distance. So what you can see here is, because I can go to this city, this is one path, initialize everything or add 1 to all these paths. Okay, now what you can do here is, now if I am at this position now, if I am at this position and I have started with this first, with this one position, I have used some fuel, which is the amount of fuel I have used, the distance between these two cities, the distance between these two cities is 2. So now I have 10 minus 2 fuel, which is 8 left. Now if I have this 8 fuel left, whichever city I can go back to, this city and so on. So then I will see that, okay, how many paths I have incoming to this city, because if I have some path incoming to this city, then only I can take that path and extend that path to other cities. I hope you're understanding this point now. Because I have to take this single path and extend it to both like other cities also, and then count out how many paths are there which is leading to the ending city. Like I will do this state which I have told you for 10, for fuel equal to 10, then fuel equal to 9 and so on. And what will I do? Then I will see that, okay, for all the fuels which I have calculated, whatever fuel or how many paths are there which will lead to the final cities if I have fuel equal to 10, 9, 8, 7 and so on. And that's the answer. I will take down to the code part to make it even more clear. So that's the code. This is the function I always use to do some modifications. If I have some mod given in the question, I always use this type 3 function, which I have also made some video. You can go and watch them on my channel. So for initialize the or store the size of the location vector, then make a vector for fuel and the position location. So the fuel dimension is like fuel plus 1, okay, because the maximum fuel can be fuel, and the positions can be for the n positions. I have make a vector, so it's a 2D vector like this. Okay, these are for fuel and these are for cities. And then what we'll do, we will initialize our fuel and the start position with 1. And then what we'll do, we will iterate over from the final fuel till 0. And then what we will do, we will, for every fuel point, what will I do, we'll iterate over for the key pairs. For if we are starting at this position, for the key pair of city, for a city on which we are, if we go from this city, from this ith city to any jth city, whether this is possible or not having this amount of fuel. So if I am going from every I city to every jth city, we will find out the difference between them, because I am going from j I to j. Okay, I have used this absolute difference. Why? Because I have told you in the question itself, the city numbers are not sorted. Like it can also happen that you go from 2 to 4, it is increasing and other can be decreasing, but we have to find out what is the absolute difference between the distance between the two cities. And then if both of these I and j are different, and f means the fuel, the distance between them is less than or equal to the fuel, then only what we can do, we will increment or we will add the number of paths ending at I, because we are going from I till j now. So the number of paths ending at I, we will increment or add those same number of paths to j, because the number of paths which are ending at I we are extending all those parts to the jth position because that will form a path. So add, this will add a function, the number of paths ending at I, take them to j, and decrement the fuel, because now I am using d amount of distance, so d amount of fuel is used. So decrement the fuel and go and take these paths to j, and then you have constructed the whole like matrix. Then what you will do in the end, total is equal to 0, how many paths are there, then iterate over all the fuel positions from 0 till equal to fuel, and all the add all the DB states in which the fuel is 0, 1, 2, 3 up to fuel, and finish. So it will tell us that if I have fuel equal to 0 and I have to reach this finish state, how many paths are there. Then I have fuel equal to 1 and I have to reach this finish state, what is the number of paths, and so on. And then we have to add this to total, and then return out the total number of paths are there. And that's the whole logic for this question. I hope you understand the logic as well as the code. If still have any doubts, please mention down. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you next one. Keep coding. Bye.